Hi friends, welcome to Prince Astrology, your one-stop astro channel. I am just trying to shoot a quick informative video that I wanted to tell you. I do not have any setup right now. Maybe I will shoot more videos like this because this will help the frequency of the video to increase, because I don't need to create any formal setup for this. I will just shoot it like a blog style and I will just talk to you informally. If you like this, do let me know. If you want more such videos, that will help me know. If you don't like this, don't kill the video. I will just shoot another video with a good setup. So just help me on that. I read your comments. Do let me know if you like this video. And if you like, do hit the subscribe and hit the bell icon, because that's what keeps you and me connected. So what happened is that in today's consultation, one of my clients told me that he was supposed to go into a good time, but what happened is that he went into a bad time. What made him go into a bad time? He was not knowing that. So when he asked me, I even immediately saw something going on there. And I immediately told him that you are under a certain kind of planetary formation. And that planetary formation is actually causing that problem, because that planetary formation was overlooked by that person. And I don't think anyone will overlook, because this is in the world of negative astrology. That means if you want to do negative predictions, this is the first thing that you will take a look into this. And this video will explain about something which is negative. So if you don't want to watch this video, you have to stop here, because what I'm going to tell is slightly negative. There is no need to be afraid or fearful if you have this. Many people, a lot of people will have at least to some extent this yoga. So don't need to worry. This only is a worrisome under a certain condition that we will discuss in the video later. So watch it till the end so that you get to know more about this yoga. Or this is not even a yoga, this is a formation of a horoscope, and this has to be applied in various cases. This is known as Shadashtak yoga or the 6-8 formation. Shadashtak yoga is very simple. It is formed, as you can see, Shad means 6 and Asht means 8. So whenever 6 and 8 houses comes into play. But how? Shadashtak means when there are two planets forming a 6-8 combination among themselves. Now let us take this example. Here Venus and Jupiter are 6 and 8 from each other. Jupiter is 8 houses away from Venus, and Venus is 6 houses away from Jupiter. So this formation of planet is known as 6-8 formation or Shadashtak formation. Most of the time it is not a dosh or something like that, but when it will create some problem, you have to see if their Mahadasha Antardasha is coming, then only this planetary formation will create some hurdles. And that has to be analyzed, but this can give some negative result. For example, if you are under Venus Mahadasha and then Jupiter Antardasha comes into picture, not Pratyantardasha, Antardasha. Because if there is a Pratyantardasha and Antardasha is of some other planet, that will create a disruption in this. So you have to check if Jupiter Mahadasha or Venus Antardasha or Venus Mahadasha Jupiter Antardasha comes. Then you are entering into a Mahadasha Antardasha of two planets who are anti to each other, because they are 6-8. To each other. Now why it is anti? Sixth house means house of loans, house of enemies, house of disputes. Eighth house means house of negative events, sudden ups and downs, fears, hurdles, struggles. All these things are ruled in the eighth house. Also, 6 and 8 complements each other from the perspective of negative side of life. How? Eighth house is third from sixth, and we all know that third from any house is known as capability of that house, the parakram, the strength of that house has to be seen, and how that house is going to express. If a person faces a severe disease, how will that disease express itself? As death. If there is a prolonged and continuous recurring disease in your body, how is that going to express itself? As a chronic disease. Similarly, What happens when there is a sudden twist in your life? There is a dispute that you gain, either you take up a loan, or you catch a disease, something negative. I'm talking only from the negative side. So what happens is that 6th house goes 11th from 8th. So that is gain of 8th house. So if 8th house has to gain, he has to gain from the 6th house. So when 6-8 combination comes into picture, the negativity rises slightly. Although you have to see that there has to be nullifying effects, Navamsha has to be seen, hundreds of factors has to be seen. But I'm talking about only one angle. So please don't start judging your horoscope with this. Only if you have it, stay cautious if you are under his Mahadasha and Antardasha. Now, mostly Kadashtak Yog or Kadashtak Dosh is seen during horoscope matching. That means during the synastry, when the person comes with a horoscope match to another partner, then you have to see if Moon and Ascendant are forming a Kadashtak Yog, especially Moon. Now, 6th and 8th means they will become enemy to each other. Why? Because if planet A is 8th from planet B, say for example here, if Jupiter is 8th from Venus, which means what? Jupiter is placed at the house of death of Venus. So Jupiter becomes the reason of death for any property created by Venus or any attribute that is expressed by Venus. And what happens for Venus? Venus becomes the enemy of Jupiter, and that enmity is created because of the position of 6th house. So Jupiter will gain obstruction, hurdles, diseases, anything that can stop the property of Jupiter being expressed from wherever Jupiter is placed. So in this way, they stop the property of each other, they stop their expression, they stop their attributes, they stop their indications, and because of this mutual play of warlike situation, this yoga becomes harmful. So whenever the two planets are in Kadashtak position and you fall into Mahadasha Antardasha, that is a time of caution. You have to be careful at that time, and you need advice of a learned astrologer how to pass that time and whether you should start something new, because a lot of factors are involved here. But if you face this, it's a problem. Next, during horoscope match, Moon defines nature. And if the two planets forms a kind of a Kadashtak Yoga in the horoscope, for example, the moon of the boy is in Aries, whereas the moon of the girl is in Virgo. Now, in that case, Aries and Virgo are Kadashtak, 6 and 8 from each other. Then their nature will be very anti, and you can know just by this example, Aries is fiery, Aries is ambitious, whereas Virgo is practical. Practical means calculative, where Aries is, I will take chances. So they are anti. So Kadashtak shows that you are anti to each other. This can also be used during business partnerships. Now, in business partnership, if your business partner and your moon are Kadashtak, you should be careful that your nature is not going to be that compatible. Now, say for example, you want to do something and you are just randomly checking this, you just don't want to go to an astrologer. How will you immediately check whether that time is good for you or not? Look at the transit of Moon whenever you have that question. If Moon is 6th house or 8th house from your natal Moon, then you should be cautious from whatever you're trying to do. Now, I know that this kind of formation will be roughly about 4.5 to 5 days per month, but this is what it is. You just need to be cautious. You don't need to stop your work. You just have to be slightly cautious, because this means that while doing that task, even if the task gets completed, because whether the completion of the task will happen is defined by Dasha and Mahadasha, you may feel a bit frustrated, some mental blockages may come. You know, a lot of times you know that it happens. It happens with all of us that we start something with a hope that it will go smooth. The task completes, but with a lot of hurdles. And those hurdles are silly, ridiculous, small. And we say that sometimes the paperwork is not correct. Sometimes you have to travel to and fro four or five times. Sometimes suddenly the things break. Sometimes you misplace some objects, say car keys. So these small events happen because Moon forms a Kadashtak formation. And you have to observe and start observing from this day. Calculate all the Kadashtak formations of according to your chart, and observe how those 4 or 5 days went. Every time it will not go bad, obviously. It's not like those 5 days are hell for you, but you have to observe. If one negative event which is a main, a prominent, a primary thing happens with your nature at that time, or you feel sad, you feel bad, you feel guilty, or a fight happens, that's the result of the Kadashtaka Yoga. Now, how will you look at? For example, you have Taurus Rashi or Vrishabh Rashi. My dear guys, I'm not talking about ascendant, I'm talking about moon zodiac, Vedic moon zodiac. So if you have, say, Taurus ascendant, Taurus Vedic moon sign. So in case of Taurus or Vrishabh Rashi, you have to see if moon is transiting Libra or moon is transiting Sagittarius. So if moon is transiting Libra, it becomes 6th from Taurus. And if moon is transiting Sagittarius, it becomes 8th from Taurus. Here, if moon is transiting Libra, but moon transits the same house lord, because your Rashi lord is Venus and moon transits the same Rashi lord, still it is Kadashtaka. That means there will be a kind of a conflict within your mind or within your own thoughts. So for example, there won't be a conflict from outside, there will be a conflict from within. For example, you are only contradicting your words, or you just encountered or stumbled that you have done a mistake. So that kind of conflict may come. Now take another example. Say you have Leo ascendant. In case of Leo ascendant, if moon is transiting Capricorn or moon is transiting Pisces, this moon is forming Kadashtaka Yoga. So you have to just check from the transit. You should know your moon Rashi, and you just find out which moon is transiting your 6th Rashi from your own Rashi and 8th Rashi from your own Rashi. Check that dates, observe. Just this information I am trying to give you, because sometimes we miss this information. Sometimes we just think that it is a, you know, there are few activities that depresses us, that demoralizes us. I just want you to be uplifted. And if you see that in your horoscope that, okay, moon is in 6th from your own natal moon, and this is the reason you are kind of sad today, then you should understand you are not the reason for that. You just need to pull up your socks. This is a planetary formation. Pass the 2 days. Party, enjoy, chill, meditate, relax, and proceed as usual, business as usual. And you should not worry too much about if this yoga is present in your horoscope. But yes, this is a negative yoga, let me tell you, and it will give its negative result under certain conditions. Kadashtaka yoga can also be seen from many other factors. For example, if there are two planets in your horoscope who is having Kadashtaka yoga, that means 6th formation, and if they're debilitated, if they are retrograde, if their dispositor is bad, or if they are afflicted, then this Kadashtaka yoga can cause some serious trouble. Then you have to take remedies for this Kadashtaka yoga. So this is a kind of a negative yoga that I encountered. I don't want to create any negative vibrations here. Just you have to understand that it's always good to know your enemy, so it prepares you to fight the battle and win quite easy. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching Puneet's Astrology. This is your astrologer Puneet. I hope you like this style of video. If you like, I will shoot more videos like this, maybe outdoors, because that will make me very easy, because I'm just shooting from my iPhone. I hope the quality is good. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching and bearing me all this long. And more videos coming soon. Stay tuned. Seek the light.